Hey, are you having a tough time understanding the return you're getting on your investment in advertising? Well, stick around because today I'm going to show you how to solve that problem. Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of Marketing Minutes. My name is Kevin, and today I'm going to show you how to properly track your marketing efforts to help you make the right decisions on where to invest your money. There are three steps you need to follow for this to work. So I'm gonna go through all three of them. And at the end, I'll show you a dashboard that we're currently using with our customer to help them make decisions on where to invest their money. So let's get right into it. So the first thing you need to do is make sure that you are tracking the right information. There are five data points that you absolutely have to track properly across all the different channels you're investing in. That is the click traffic, so how many visitors your landing page or website is getting from the investment you're making, how much of investment you are making, so the cost data, your media spend if you want. The third one are the leads that come about from this traffic that you're sending to your website or landing page. Number four, what closed from those leads, so the sales. And then number five is the revenue that those sales generated for you. Once you have those five data points that are properly tracked, then you can move forward into performing certain calculations with that data to get insight. And that insight you gain will allow you to make the right decisions on where to invest your money. The second step is now taking your data and creating calculations from that data in order to get the insight that you need. So let me explain. Most contractors have a tendency of looking at the cost per lead in order to make decisions on where to invest their money. We sometimes come across contractors who try to get the most leads at the lowest cost per lead possible. Unfortunately, that's not the metric that we normally use here to make the financial decisions, simply because we've seen many times scenarios where contractors were purchasing leads at a very low cost, and yet it took a large volume of leads in order to generate a sale. So when you know that information, what you need to do is to calculate your customer acquisition costs. That is an important metric that lets you know across each of the channels that you're advertising, how much does it cost your business to acquire a customer across each of these channels. It is super important. A lot of our decisions of where to invest money are based on the lowest customer acquisition cost. The other metric that we look at is the cost over revenue ratio. It's basically taking your cost divided by the total revenue. The reason we do that is to measure what percentage of your costs is represented in your revenue. What we wanna do is we wanna get a percentage that's extremely low. And from this calculation, we're able to determine for every dollar that you're investing, either in radio, on Google, on Facebook, how much revenue it's generating for you in return. When you have that information, it helps you make decisions on where to invest your money, because just logically, you'll want to go and invest your money in sources that have a low customer acquisition cost or in sources that have a low cost over revenue percentage, because that is an indicator that for every dollar you're putting in, you're getting a good amount of revenue in return. The other two things you want to measure is your revenue per sale and your return on ad spend. So revenue per sale is going to give you insight across all the channels where you're making the most revenue on every sale that you make. That's going to have an impact on where you should be investing your money. It's to maximize your sales rep's time. The return on ad spend is a metric that we use in order to calculate whatever money's left over after we've taken a revenue and deducted the investments that we made to acquire that revenue. That gives us an idea also on where we should be investing our money. If we're not making a whole lot of money after investing in a certain channel, well, it doesn't really make financial sense to continue. So that's why we take that metric into consideration. We want to calculate where to invest our money. All right, so the third step you have to follow in order to properly assess where to invest your money is to take all this data you've been gathering and have it visually represented somewhere so you could easily assess the data. To do that, we use a combination of things. We'll use Google Sheets or Excel to be able to extract the raw data and in order for us to manipulate the data. And then to represent it properly, we'll use a tool like Data Studio. Data Studio is a free tool that's provided by Google, so I really highly suggest you guys have a look at it if you're not already using something. And in Data Studio, it gives us the ability to grab everything that we have in Excel and do our own calculations within Data Studio if you want, so that the data we have looks nice and the insight that we're looking for is well represented. Let me go and show you what that actually looks like. Here's an example of a dashboard we put together to show you how you can grab all this raw data and these calculations and just visually represent it on a dashboard so that you can understand what's happening with your business a little bit better. There's three pages to this dashboard. So I'm gonna go through each page and do it pretty quick, but I'm gonna explain to you the insight and the benefits of having your data sort of represented this way. On page one, what we wanna do is show some of the overall performance of the company. So top left, we have total revenue broken down by month. On the right side of that, we have the revenue broken down by lead source in a pie chart so that visually you can quickly see which are the top two, three lead sources that are driving most of your revenue. And here you can clearly see that 43% of your revenue is coming from a loyalty program or previous customers or referrals that you're getting from your previous customers. Second section, basically your total leads broken down by month. And one thing you wanna see when you're looking at a bar chart like this is you wanna see a staircase effect. What the staircase effect explains to you or shows you is that if you're consistently investing the same amount of money month over month, you want to get more and more leads for that same amount of investment that you're making. It's a good sign that if you're working with a company, they're doing a good job at optimizing your campaigns because you're getting more bang for your buck. At the bottom here, is an example in case you have multiple locations. So you wanna take your results and break it down for each of the locations so that you know if there's a location that's costing you a lot more to acquire a customer than another location, it would make logical sense to sort of move your funds around. Put less money maybe in your advertising in that area and put it more where you're getting the lowest customer acquisition cost. So when we show the results this way, in our example here, we got five locations, and what we're showing is what did we invest for each of the locations, how many leads did it generate, the sales, what's my customer acquisition cost broken down for each of these locations, and so forth. That way we could visually see, for example here, that in one location, we're acquiring customers at $507, whereas there are other locations that we're acquiring those customers at just above $200. So right there, logically, it would make sense to maybe take our budget that we have for one of the locations that's costing us a lot and move it towards the other two. On page two, what we did is we decided to take all of our data and break it down for each of the lead sources that we're investing in. This is very important at the end of the year when you analyze your results to make decisions on where to spend your budget for the following year. This is a quick and easy way to visually see where you're winning and where you're losing in regards to your investments. So when we're noticing areas that have a high customer acquisition cost, those are areas that we might want to use the funds differently. We might want to pull it away from those sources and put them more towards sources that we're able to get customers at a lower cost. For example, on line 16, our home and garden show, we're acquiring customers at $5,000 from that event. It's way too expensive compared to the average that we have in our account. So this is a great area that we're gonna go ahead and maybe not invest heavily next year, maybe not go to the show and just use that money differently. On page three, what we wanted to do is take the results and break it down for each of the cities, for each of the publishers that we're investing a lot of money in. That's important because the story that we get from this or the insight that we get really sort of tells us where to move the funds around. So for example, if I move down here to year-to-date results for Facebook, you'll see broken down for each of the cities that in Columbus and Denver, our customer acquisition cost is extremely high compared to the three other locations. So this is a clear telltale sign that we should be taking the money that we're investing in those two cities and potentially move them into the other three that we're getting the best results to maximize our potential there first. And if there's money left over in the budget, then we'll continue advertising in the other two locations to try and optimize them a little bit more over time. But while that optimization process is taking place, we're not wasting a whole lot of money. We're really consistently maximizing their investment as much as possible. So that's what this particular type of view allows us to quickly see. And when we sit down with customers every month to review the data, together we make these types of decisions on where to move their money around. So there you have it. We went through the three steps that you need to follow in order to have the information at your fingertips to make the right decisions on where to invest your marketing dollars. Step one is to make sure you have the five metrics that are important: clicks, cost, leads, sales, revenue. Number two is to make sure that once you have that data, make the right calculations. The two most important metrics you need to calculate is your customer acquisition cost and your cost over revenue ratio. Once you have all that insight, you can use Data Studio and Google Sheets to have it visually represented in the dashboard, so at a glance, you can easily see where you're winning and where you're losing. That's it for today's Marketing Minutes episode. If you like the content, then subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button so you get notified the next time we post new content. And I'll see you on the next video. Hey everyone, my name is Kevin. Oh, sorry. So stay tuned. I'm Kevin, and today I'm gonna explain to you what we do. Boom.